folks, Will from MinIO here with a how-to on streaming uploads to MinIO with Python. And in this video, we're going to be using Python 3.9. Our MinIO Python client API is compatible with 3.7 and above. And we're going to be uploading our stream to play.min.io, which is our online sandbox where anybody can work with the MinIO platform. And finally, we're going to be running all of this out of VS Code, Visual Studio Code. And to dig into a little bit of what you'll be able to do once you've watched this video, we're going to show you how to use the put object method with all of the various variables that you can use to put a stream onto MinIO as an object. In particular, we're going to be looking at the part sizes and stream lengths, which can come in handy when you're dealing with a stream of unknown length. And last, we're going to be checking our results so that you can see that you actually uploaded your stream. So let's go ahead and dig into our code. Okay, and here in our code, you can see that I've imported MinIO, and I've also imported the MinIO demo functions, which gives me a collection of functions that allows me to do some scaffolding so we can just focus on the code we want to see. Also, I've added an import for IO because I'm going to be working with some byte streams and a file stream to show you how the streaming works. I've set up a few variables here. The bucket name that I'm going to be connecting to is Python demo bucket. I'm also going to be uploading to an object that I've arbitrarily named Hello World Text. Its content type is text plain. Now there's also a file name here, but the file name is really involved with when I'm going to be working with a file stream here in just a minute. In order to get all this running, I've actually also called the play connect method in the MinIO demo functions. This actually gives me a client so that I can work with objects and streams on our MinIO platform on play.min.io. So in order to actually run this, what I'm going to do is I am calling the put object method. Now, at a base level, it needs to have a bucket name, an object name, the stream of data that it's going to be uploading, and also a length. Now, there are other fields that you can add. In this case, I've also added in a content type. You can also do metadata. You can also set up a part size for multi-parts. You can do tags, retentions, legal holds, and all that other fun stuff. But just as a base level here, I'm giving it a bucket name of Python demo bucket. I'm giving it an object name of Hello World Text. And I've given it this byte stream, which is literally just a string of bytes. It is Hello World with an exclamation mark. That is 12 bytes long. That's the length that I've got there. And then I've also given it this content type. So let me go ahead and run this, Python 3, demo.py. And when I run this, I get my Hello World text uploaded. It's got an E tag and a version ID. My bucket is versioned right now. What you'll see if I run this again is I'll get the same E tag, but a different version ID because it's a new version. One other thing I can show you here, if I change the length, then it's not going to upload the entire string. It'll just upload the first 11 characters, basically trimming off that exclamation mark. If I go ahead and save and then run this, you'll notice that I get a different E tag. That's because the object itself has changed and therefore the hash code has changed. So my E tag is a little different. I also get a different version ID. Again, it's a new version. So that is uploading a stream. Now I'm using a stream whose length I actually know the length of. What if I'm using something where I don't know the full length? So for instance, I'm going to upload this file. So I'm going to change this to file.io and I'm going to upload the file name, fname. Okay. So this is going to read a file, hwtext. Now hwtext has a certain length. It's longer than 11 bytes. I know that, but I don't know off the top of my head how long it is. So what I do in order to set an unknown length is I give the code this -1. So if I give the code -1, I save it so I can upload something of an unknown length. If I run this one more time, I actually have an error. And you have to have a valid part size if the object size is unknown. This is so MinIO knows how to partition stuff. So to add a part size is unfortunately not the next item in my list of variables. So I have to say part size first. If I give it a part size and then try to run this one more time, I'm going to find out that I actually have to have a specific part size. The minimum allowed is 5 meg. So what I've given it is basically 1024. That's essentially 1K. So we're going to multiply this by another 1024 to get to a meg, and then we're going to multiply it by 5 to get to 5 megs. And now when I run this one more time, there we go. I have now uploaded this Hello World text object from a file stream. I've got a certain etag coming out of that and a certain version ID coming out of that. And that's everything that you need to know to upload a stream to MinIO. I hope you've enjoyed our how-to today. If you'd like to reach out to us, you can use any of the methods that you see here on the screen. You can also chat with us interactively on Slack at minio.slack.com, or you can just give us a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.